Oh, my beautiful vibe tribers, welcome to your mystic affirmations for Monday, January the 18th of 2021. Many blessings to you all. For those of you who are new to this reading, this is not your standard tarot reading. We're using the law of affirmations and the law of attraction. It's the law of compensation, really, and allowing yourself to manifest the best possible life you have in front of you, the taking the energy that we are experiencing now and pulling through whatever situation that is not in alignment with what we are wanting to move forward to and bringing that energy in. So not everything is peachy keen all the time. So remember that what you're manifesting doesn't have to be your current situation. That's the whole point, is we're manifesting past what we're experiencing into what we want our lives to be. So, with that being said, if you'd like a private reading, please visit my website, royalmystic.com. I'll always be happy to assist you once you schedule your appointment. And royalmystic.com is the hub of all things Royal Mystic. The Curiosity Shop has a direct link there. If you'd like to find out about cards or crystals, jewelry, things that are on there, all the curiosities. And then we also have a link to help you learn more about the Vibe Tribe. If you want to be a Vibe Tribe member, we have weekly workshops and daily meditation, so you'll get to explore that. So, without any further ado, we have the Nine of Swords and the Princess of Swords, which in this deck is Princess, but in Standard Tarot is the Page. So, we have this Nine of Swords, and you see she is under attack, and this is her own thoughts that are doing this to her. So, anxiety and fear, allowing it to overtake you. Now, listen, it's not always generated by you, but you can certainly pick it up and carry it and make it worse for yourself. So just understand that this is not something that is an absolute that you have to keep. Now, we all experience these moments, but you don't have to stay in this moment. And see, there's nothing holding those swords there. It's all her that she's drawing it to her like a magnet. Now, the good news is that at the Nine of Swords means that you're ripe for a breakthrough. So when you have the Nine of Swords, that means the Ten of Swords is coming next, and that means that it is being released and the cycle is ending. So the good news is you've got that Tenth Sword coming in over here with this Princess, and she's got the illumination going. You see how she's using her light? The sword is to become a light. She is bending the sword to the frequency of the light rather than the dark. So when you allow yourself to bring that illumination in, it takes away all that shadow energy and you're allowed to move forward. So it's all about you taking control and saying, you know what? I'm going to think of this in a different way. This is just my fear of what might happen. And because I'm stepping out of my comfort zone, it's feeling like something bad. It does not mean it is. So try to change your thought process. You don't have to change the fear. You just have to change the way you see it. There you go. So with that being said, let's go into our beautiful energy. Thank you, angels, archangels, divine, pure, white light, divine spirit, spirit guides, gods and goddesses. Thank you so much for being present here to allow everyone to have the information they seek to assist them in remaining on their highest possible spiritual path. We thank you so much, Divine, for these blessings and beautiful messages, and we receive them in the love and light for which they are intended. We thank you for this divine guidance as always, and we welcome this blessed energy. Thank you so much, Divine. Okay, so we have our three cards down. And our underlier, the Three of Swords. 3 days, 3 weeks, 3 months, third time's a charm. I say that because I was given this card as a timekeeper when I started my journey. This is the thing. The cards reveal what they mean to the reader. And they don't all mean the same thing to every person. I think you can, thank you for allowing me to have a drink of water. I think you can honestly say that the energy of the reader is what brings forth the message. So that's part of it. Just think of it looking through the lens. The lens is the reader, and the lens is the one who's kind of focusing in the energy. So for me, it's the timekeeper. 3 days, 3 weeks, 3 months, or time's a charm. And the reason you don't hear me saying 3 years is because I don't forecast out that far. Not intentionally, anyway. We have visualization. I make mental pictures of my goals that are simple and to the point. Now, what's the simplest way to make it a simple and to the point picture? What's the end result that you want? Picture that. That's all you have to do. Truly, don't go around the bush. Don't get into all the details. What do I want? How do I want to feel? Get into that energy, feel the feeling of it, and you change the vibration. And that's how you receive it quickly. That's manifestation at the very simplest terms. For those of you who want to know how to manifest, that's as simple as it is. Awareness. When I focus on positive energy, I am aware that I attract more of it. This is where we have to change our perspective if we find ourselves too bent on the negative. You don't have to turn that energy, like whatever that event is, you don't have to specifically turn that event, but just shift your mind to focus on something, puppies and kittens. I have done that before when I'm looking at something that's atrociously horrifying. I snap out of it by using puppies and kittens. I got that from somebody, I don't know where, but it was talking about how to shift your energy because your brain cannot think more than one thought at a time. Spiritually, you can be multifractal, but your logical mind cannot focus on more than one thought at a time. So if it's beaten down on this negative energy for a thought, switch the thought. Something that brings you joy and happiness. Go to your happy place. That's a real thing. So let's see what the... Change your awareness. There we go. We have the energy here of the angels. No need to worry. Release the fear. There we go. The angels have our back. No need to worry. It doesn't do any good other than make you low vibe. It just attracts all the negative stuff to you the minute you turn on that. Think of it like turning on a harmonic tune, like a tuning fork. So you have positive and negative. Turn on the positive one. Turn off the negative one. Resonate with the positivity. Positivity. Yes, I'm goofy. But that's why I am a happy person. I let myself do silly things. Crown chakra. The frequency of the crown chakra is the violet flower of life, which is beautifully reflected in my nail polish today. It supports our spiritual connection to the universe and our ability to transmute negative energy into light. Isn't that cool? We were talking about transmuting energy earlier. There you go. Crown chakra. This one is an extraordinarily good card, I feel, especially for these times. My body is always working toward optimum health. My body wants to be whole and healthy. I cooperate and become healthy, whole, and complete. Louise Hay, these are awesome cards. Thank you for them. Thank you for bringing them into this world. I listen with love to my body's messages. These are power thought cards by Louise Hay. That's what the box looks like. Just, I know somebody out there wants to know, so there you are. Whoever you are, I heard you. My body is always working toward optimum health. My body wants to be whole and healthy. I cooperate and become healthy, whole, and complete. I listen with love to my body's messages. That's part of the awareness. You're getting messages from all around. And once you become aware, you can't put that genie back in the bottle, guys. Believe me. When you start becoming, when you start listening and they realize you're hearing them, the wonderful energies around you will continue to speak, and more of them will. Not in a negative way. You'll just realize how much you've been pushing out thinking it was not something important. Everything is working out for my best and highest good. Out of this situation, only good will come. I am safe. And as I do, I added a word in there, for my highest good. I put my best and highest good. Ad lib is great. All is well in my world. Everything is working out for my highest good. Out of this situation, only good will come. I am safe. Absolutely. All is well in my world. Remember, we're manifesting. We're bringing it in. And if you already have that energy and you've got that working, we're just affirming. We're just helping tie it down some more. Add some more gasoline to that tank. Keep it running. Four of Pentacles. Solid, stable energy. Money in the bank. This is very grounded energy. It means having a good grip on your finances, not having it being, you know, coming in, going out really fast, just being in a place of where you do get to retain what you need to retain. King of Cups, beautiful energy of authentic offer, authentic care, whoever this is. If it's a job offer, it's a company worth working for, or a person worth working for, somebody who genuinely cares about their employees and wants their lives to be enhanced through the job. Some places are actually like that, believe it or not, and it's a really good energy. Now, if this energy is you or someone near you, this is them displaying or you displaying the feelings of love and authentic, solid, real emotion and caring energy. This, that King of Cups is very solid. Ooh, the World card. We love this. Genesis pattern going on there. This is the manifestation of a new beginning, an upgrade, stepping through the looking glass. Always a really good, cool energy, which means a higher position or a higher vibration. So whether it's spiritual or physical, emotional, financial, it's up. Higher position. Very happy energy here. Many blessings to you all. Have a beautiful Monday. Love, light, and abundance to you. Healing and blessings. I'll see you again tomorrow. Namaste.